If you just bought a graphic or stream overlay package from own.tv, I'm gonna show you in this video right here how to load it into OBS Studio and to Streamlabs OBS so that way you'll be up and running within just moments. Let's go. All you awesome streamers, Wild for Games here to make your stream bigger and better. And if this is your first time here and you need tips and tricks, how-tos, or awesome tutorials, make sure you hit that big red subscribe button and tick that bell so you know when my videos go live for you. If you've already bought your graphic and stream overlay package from Owned, awesome, congratulations, it's gonna look great. If you haven't just yet and you're considering it, you can go through my link down in my video description below to save some extra cash. By the way, those really help support my channel, so thank you very much. Once you've completed the download, you're gonna notice all the files come within a zip folder. I recommend taking these out of zip folder for easy access and also making a backup copy just in case something bad happens you have to go back to. Now let's start off with OBS. Whenever you use OBS Studio and you wanna add new scenes and sources, it's basically the same steps over and over. So when you have free time, customize the stream the way you want. I'm gonna show you how to do the basics so that way you have the building blocks to customize your stream. Let me show you how to drop in a basic starting soon scene and source for your stream. When you open up OBS Studio, make sure you title a new scene and go to the plus sign under sources. From here, we wanna load the appropriate graphic. If it's going to be a static image, you're gonna go to image. If it's gonna be anything animated, you're gonna wanna go to media source. Title your graphic what's gonna be easily rememberable for you and click OK. All you need to do is locate the asset you wanna load in. For Owned's files, they're all neatly organized under files and within their corresponding folder. So simply just find the one you want and load it in. If the source is an animated one, I really recommend clicking on loop so that way it can keep going through the animated cycle and look seamless. When you've made all the adjustments to your scene and source, all you have to do is click OK. And there you go, you got a starting soon screen within moments and it was really, really easy. Now when it comes to adding more scenes and sources to your stream, it's a lot of the same steps over and over. You just gotta make sure you pick the appropriate scene and source an asset and you're up and running within moments. So take time to customize it. Now, if you wanna use any of the transitions, all you have to do is go over to the scene transition section. From here, click on the plus sign and click on Stinger. Select the video file you want for your video transition, make any adjustments that you need to in the settings and click OK. Now, when we switch between scenes here, you're gonna see the awesome Stinger transitions that you purchased from Owned. Now, when it comes to using all the alerts and sound effects, you can't do that through OBS Studio. You have to use a third-party provider that uses triggered events and alerts. So you're gonna be looking at something like Streamlabs or Stream Elements. And all you do is just use their alert widget boxes and load in those assets and you'll be good to go. See how easy it was to import all the graphics and assets into those scenes and sources on OBS Studio? Just take some time to customize it and really build a stream you're gonna be proud of. Now let's move on to Streamlabs OBS. When it comes to loading in your graphics and stream overlays into Streamlabs OBS, it's really simple. In fact, it's pretty much just the same exact steps as OBS Studio. So if you're familiar with that, this is gonna be a breeze. Let me show you how to drop in an easy starting soon scene and source so that way you'll be up and running. And just to let you know, it's basically the same steps over and over so that way you can craft your stream the way you want. This is just the basics to get you going. To drop in an awesome starting soon scene, all you need to do is title out a scene and get the appropriate source from Owned. All you need to do is click on the plus sign right next to sources. If your scene is gonna be static, you wanna go with image. If it's gonna be an animated one, you wanna go with media source. Click on add new source and give it a title. From here, locate the appropriate file that you wanna display as your starting soon scene. If you're gonna use an animated graphic scene source or element, I really recommend putting it on loop so that way it will have seamless transitions as it restarts. When you're all done making the adjustments that you need, go ahead and click done. And there you go, you've got an awesome starting soon screen that just loaded in moments. Now, like I said, it's the same steps over and over, depending on what scene and source you wanna craft for, you know, your just chatting and gameplay. So have fun and craft what you want, but now you know how to drop everything in till you get going within moments. Now, when it comes to transitions, that's gonna be under a different section. To add the appropriate transition that we got from Owned, you wanna go over to the gearbox that's under your scenes. Click on Edit Scene Transition, And when this loads, you can either add a new transition or edit the one that you currently have here. I'm gonna go on edit and go under type and select stinger. From here, we can choose the file that we wanna load for our stinger transition. Simply select the appropriate one that you want and load it in and make any adjustments that you need to for your transition. Once you're done and you switch between scenes, you will see your awesome, beautiful stinger transition that you got from Owned. See what I tell you? Super simple. Now, if you purchased your graphic and stream package from Owned and you're using Streamlabs OBS and OBS Studio, you have to do things more or less manually, one scene and source at a time. It gives you a lot of, you know, customization, but it can be kind of a slog. However, if you use Streamlabs OBS, you can purchase Owned stream and graphic packages directly from the theme store and you can install them super simple. So let me show you that as a bonus. Within Streamlabs OBS, go up to the themes. When you've loaded up a theme that you found that you like, for instance, I'm gonna be using this neon one that you've been seeing here, simply click on it. Once you've completed your purchase, or if you're a Streamlabs Prime member, go to install overlay. Once it's done installing, guess what? You're done. One click installation. It comes with all the appropriate scenes and sources in the correct spots, and it comes with all the stinger transitions already loaded for what you need. And if you want to make any customizations, all you got to do is just move them around within the source window. Nice and easy. Streamlabs makes it very good for anyone that's brand new to this platform. Now, if you suffer with anything OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS and you need a little bit extra help, you can leave me a comment down below and I will see what I can do to make a video for you to help you out. Until next time, all of you awesome streamers, stay pretty, stay beautiful, keep streaming, and of course, peace.